getting a woman wet. You find a lot of men have confusion in this, or like a needed assistance with just kind of breaking down how to go about doing this process. Because truthfully, I have my ways. They've worked, you know, with years of research and data, you know, I'm going to share my tips. But from you, like, is this coming from
practical,
like
me? Practical experience. Copious notes.
Yes. But for the men out there, do you find like this is something that they're really, there's a lack of knowledge of, and they just truthfully don't know?
I would say it's probably half. Yeah, it's probably half and half. I think that men, I am always surprised at the reactions that I get from men from some of my videos. Cause I would think like, oh, this is common knowledge, but I think men struggle because they're not getting laid, or they're not, you know, I think they're turning off women, or women, because women are very, you know, it's the little things that add up for us. We're not easy to crack the code. So it's like little tiny things that you have to do to like unwrap the wrapper. You can't just like unwrap it and it's like, oh, surprise. Men, that's men. Like, just take your clothes off and let's go. Like that's how simple it is with men. But with women, I just feel that they are, you know, if you say one wrong thing, or if you come at us in a certain way, it's like it can trigger something and then we can shut down. And so it's not that men don't necessarily know, it's that women are just a little bit more unpredictable than men. So I wanted to make a splash because I thought, let me just, I don't
splash.
Know. I
mean, hey, nice.
ding. My YouTube is obviously new. I'm trying to kind of understand, like, and I have plenty of other ones that are planned, but I thought, let me kind of see what the reception is with this one. And those are the things that have worked on me, in regards to the things that I talked about. So I don't know. What do you think? You tell me what your things have been, and I want to hear. So I want to like have I have never heard these before. People that are listening, so
yeah,
I'll be able to tell you.
This is a genuine live reaction here. So, but I won't say all. You have 10 points, and I'm not going to, you know, say them on the podcast, because again, guess what, guys? Go to her channel and watch it and leave a comment because they're good. But there's some that I want to touch on that are kind of collaborate with mine. So let me go to my list real quick. You mentioned make them laugh. Yes. Making a woman laugh is critical. And that's one thing I had if I'm with anybody, I'm just very fun. I don't care who you are, how pretty you are. I'm just going to make you laugh. And just, I'm very humble. Sometimes I poke fun at myself sometimes, but making a woman laugh is, you have to do that. That's one part of it. So again, that collaborates with your list. The other one I have is be confident. In yourself, and be comfortable in your own skin and be aware of your strengths. That's all kind of one bullet point. Well, the other one I have, you mentioned kisser. You have to be a great kisser and know how to kiss. Know when to go firm. God. You know when to go firm and when to be soft. And there's a lot of women don't know how to kiss either. Yeah.
Oh, trust me. I can tell if somebody's emotionally available or not by the way they kiss. Like it is, some people are just worst. And it is, it's an immediate game changer.
I had this one woman, I remember we went out and we were going to start kissing, and I lean in and she literally just sticks her tongue out at me. And I'm like, what are you doing? And I'm like, I went in, it was the most awkward kiss I've ever had. I'm like, what is she doing? She just thought kissing was sticking your tongue out.
Well, isn't that the worst thing? I've had, I call it lizard tongue, where I've had guys.
Sorry.
You know what I'm talking about.
Yes, I know what you're talking about. Yeah.
It's like, I'm like, what is that? Like what that's not, it's the weirdest thing, but
yeah.
And it's funny because I think, wow, like you made it to 45 years old and like nobody, like I've given instruction. Like,
no, you have not.
Like, I mean, at least if they're open to it, like, I appreciate that because it tells me that like, oh, like they actually want to learn how to kiss me. Mm-hmm. But I have literally sat on the couch and I'm like, go, no, don't do that. Do this. Like, and I have flat out given.
That is so sad.
A masterclass on kissing. Cause I'd like to think that I no. I mean, I'm a good kisser, like I've been told. And so you learn, you just know
after
like, a while.
And I don't, not to toot my own horn either, but I consider myself a Jedi in kissing, because I love kissing. And get this, there's one move I'm gonna share a move with you. One move I did that I didn't know that women loved, because I grew up watching movies, and I noticed in Superman 2, whenever Clark Kent kissed Lois, he put his hands on her cheeks and he leaned in and kissed her. So I remember whenever I would lean in, I'd do this and just put my hands around her cheeks and her neck. How can I describe it? But just like this.
Yeah, I know. Yeah.
And I'd reach in and I kiss. And when I did that, they would always, they'd react like no one's ever done that. And it worked for me. And again, you have to learn how to be soft and also firm whenever the moment is appropriate.
Yes.
So that's the hand move.
That's great. That's great advice. No, that's great advice.
Thank you.
And don't just like go in for the jugular, you know, like take your time. Mm-hmm. Don't just like stick your tongue down our throat. It's a very, and the biting of the lip and like the,
yes, the sucking of the bottom of the lip.
Yep. Like pulling and pushing. And like, it's very intricate, but find a woman who, if you're listening, find a woman who will teach you how to kiss. They're out there. We're out there. We will help you.
Yes. Yes. And have a great smile. That's one thing that I noticed. But the most important thing that every woman I dated told me, and I found it an odd compliment, is like, you make me feel safe. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, what? So and big. Again, I haven't dated since the 90s. So when I first heard it, I'm like, what do you mean by that? Just, most guys, they're either angry at their ex. So as a woman, we're scared because he's drinking and we don't know whether he's going to just blow up and he's taking me home. Is he going to be mad and take it out on me? They brought up all these situations like I never thought of as a man. And I'm like, okay, so plus you weren't too sexual. You were just fun. You had a calming peace about you. You weren't angry with the world. You love what you did. All these things that I didn't know were just natural to me, but really helped me in the dating world because I had a plan, you know, I wasn't needy, but they love that. And making them feel safe. Go ahead. Sorry.
No, I can't say enough about that. I have to stop because I've had men who have sent me like links to like lingerie, right? When we just first started dating. And I'm like,
are you serious?
I'm like, what did you just do? Like it's knowing what is appropriate, but overtly sexualizing a woman, you might as well just shut the door on her vagina because you've just made her feel like she is an object and she is, it's like, be smarter, men. We don't want dick pics. We don't respond visually. We respond through our ears. And yes, I mean, again, I've dated great guys, but like they think like you can tell, you can see the toxicity from like a mile away. Like you can see it. And it's like, if guys just understood that a woman's primary instinct for her to want to sleep with you is to feel safe. And I'm not saying men, again, I have all this knowledge about men. I have to be responsible about not using it to manipulate men. It's my responsibility to understand that, like, yes, I know all this now about men, but if I use it for bad, that makes me a demon. Like that makes me even more evil than the evilest of women. So take the information, understand it, but understand that like women do want to feel safe, and we are bombarded by sexual images. We are bombarded by men who want to sleep with us, especially if she's anywhere near attractive. If she's a five or up,
that's all she hears every day.
She's getting hit on. She's getting messages that, you know, she's dealing with her own insecurities. Like all she wants is a man to say, you know, I really enjoy talking with you. I think you are just so intelligent, so well-spoken. And I want to spend more time with you, getting to know you. And it's like, it's such a breath of fresh air, because again, I think that men are missing the fact that like wait till you get her. She'll be a freak in the sheets.
Yeah.
If yeah. you just wait, like just give her time to open up and that side of her will come out. Mm-hmm. Trust me, like naturally it will come out. I'm sure that, oh, yeah. I don't know what you think about that, but
no,
if you come, you come in for the jugular, she's down. She's shutting down.
No, I never did that. Cause again, I found out, and again, I'm being truthful as a man here. I couldn't just fuck anybody. I was, mm-hmm. I'm not wired that way. There has to be an emotional connection, not love, but there has to be a chemical connection between me and this person for me mm-hmm. to function, quote unquote. I'm not like these other guys who could just put it in whatever. I don't know how right. they can do that. There's something wrong with them. But I think for a lot of men, like you said, the reason they're aggressive, I think a lot of us, like I said, we mentioned earlier, we learn the wrong way. We watch, a lot of guys watch porn, which is detrimental to relationships with women because they see that, they think that's a reality. They think to get a woman wet or whatever is do these moves that they saw in a video growing up. And that's so far from the truth. Mm-hmm. I mean, that's just fiction. That's just a movie. It's not reality. And I think fiction. A lot of men, they take that into the real world and they're impatient. They don't know how to have that communication because most movies and porn start right at the scene without any right. dialogue. So I think that's a huge influence. I think that's a huge, truthfully from a man, that's a huge influence. And there's other men that I've hung out with that speak to that. Men idolize porn stars, which is stupid because I get their beauty. I get they're great in bed, but I don't know a damn thing about them. If they're good talk women
about,
or not.
Talk about daddy issues. I mean, porn stars are known for having, poor male influences in their life. Yeah. And you go into sex work for just so much love and validation. And after my experience and going into, again, like the treatment facility and understanding mm-hmm. like why I was trying to get validation from men and what that was doing for me, I learned I had girlfriends who were on, like sugar daddy sites, who were on these particular, doing like sex work. I mean, there was a lot of sex workers that were a part of this treatment facility that I was in. And once Wow. once you see that, and once you see the dysfunction behind it, like mm-hmm. I was like, I can never look at porn again. Like it kind of fucked with my head because I was, mm-hmm. I just think like these women, very few of them are going into it with just like, sure, I just enjoy sex. Like that's, it's like,
yeah,
no, it takes a very special person to kind of go into that. And there's no judgment. It's just that I know how broken I was and I see it and my heart just wants to like help. I just want to like help them because yeah. I know, I don't know. It serves a purpose. I get it. It's an industry. People make money. But for me, I think that's why a lot of people are going like the no-fop way, because they're seeing that it can be really destructive.
It really can. A couple more things before we end the podcast. You said safe. And I think a lot of men, they get confused with that word. Like a woman wants to feel safe around you. A lot of guys I know for a fact think, okay, that means I got to be big, muscular, and know that no man's going to approach us or harm her in any way. That's how a lot of them think instead of no, she wants to feel safe from you.
Yep.
And I think that's a big thing that men need to be aware of. So, but that's how men think. We're very protective it's in our DNA, but that's how we don't really think about the other at ourselves. And I think there'd be a lot of better men out there if we took times to really work on ourselves. Because again, mm-hmm. there's pain out there. We've all been hurt by the opposite sex or somebody we love, but having that self-reflection, looking inward and saying, hey, what can I do to avoid being in the situation again, like you and I did, like going to therapy and, getting help. I think right. that would really help them out as well.
100%. We think that you're going to hurt us. Like women mm-hmm. just automatically kind of think, in our heads, we're thinking, okay, what does he want from us? He just wants to sleep with us.
Right.
He just like, and then after that, I'm going to be discarded or whatever. So a woman, for her to feel safe is yes. Like, don't talk about your ex poorly.
Please don't.
She's, automatically she's going to think like, well, I'm going to be the next ex that's mm-hmm. on the chopping block. It's like, heal yourself. you know, show up good to society, show up as a healed man. And like, that's what I will say about the red pill that I do, like Rollo Tomasi, you know, on some of these guys that talk about, you know, a man on his purpose is the most attractive thing, because it's true. Yes. A man like yourself who, you know, has purpose, has drive, who's doing good in the world, who doesn't view women as objects, that translates to, it's somebody again like yourself who's had a potential history of infidelity. I dated a guy who, I don't know how many times he cheated. We didn't even get there. Like, it was, but it was, yes, he took responsibility, but then there was always like, well, this is why I did this, or the woman, like, this woman did this, like this, like he always had an excuse for the behavior. And that, again, that does not make me want to get into a relationship with you, because that tells me then that's what's going to prevent you from cheating on me.
Right.
Like, if you're not able to take responsibility and say, this is what I need in a relationship, this is how I've learned, this is how I've grown, I'm not going to do this again because I value fidelity and like all the things that you've come to. And I've watched what you've said on your videos about what you've learned about your experience. I don't think that you would cheat again. Just knowing what I've seen in the tiny short videos that I've seen of you, it's like this man has self-reflected. He has learned from his mistakes. He understands how to communicate his wants and needs now. And there is like this, that right there is like the sexiest thing. And men, just if you're listening, please understand that. Like, that is so sexy when a man who is self-aware and knows the mistakes that he's made.
Guys, take notes. She knows what she's talking about.